Hey, hello. Can you see my screen? Can you see it? You cannot see. Can you see it? Hello.
Hello.
Can you see my screen, Prim?
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. So once again, good morning, students. Welcome to slash one. How are you today? Are you all good? I hope that you are all doing fine today. And again, let me welcome you again to our virtual class today, Monday. This is your time schedule. So before we continue, or before we begin to our new topic today, let us review what we have learned last time. Just a quick review, okay? So last time we talked about volume and capacity. So we have learned that volume is the amount of liquid in a container. Okay, so that's volume. How about capacity? Just a review. Capacity is the maximum volume of liquid a container holds. So that is capacity. And also last time we have learned the different non-standard units in measuring the volume and capacity. So these are the examples of non-standard units. So we have here cup, spoon, glass. So these are only few examples of what we call non-standard units in measuring volumes and capacities. So, yes, do you have a question? Again, please.
Today has homework.
Just wait. Okay, teacher Jong will just tell you later about your activity there. Okay, so just focus, listen, and look at the screen and follow our discussion. So thank you for that question, Jokun. I will tell you later, right? So measuring capacity using non-standard units. So these are examples. So example, we use a spoon. So the volume of water in the glass is how many tablespoons? 9. So there are 9. Yes, 9 tablespoons. Okay, another example here. So what is the volume of water in the jug?
6
cups. Yeah, so these are examples of using non-standard units. Okay, Natawat, you can erase now. It's very easy, right? So just a quick review. Now we have learned also about standard units. Can you erase that one? Let me. Okay, thank you. Thank you for that. Okay, so these are called, or this is called standard units. So there is number, okay? So for example here, the volume of water in this container, you can see here the number, right? So 100 ml.
Standard unit.
500. So this is the volume of water, 500. Milliliters, okay? 500 milliliters. So, and the capacity of this container, you can see here, is 1 liter. 1 liter. So this is. Okay, someone is talking. Let me. Okay, thank you. So this is called the capacity of a jug, 1 liter. So, remember class, 1 liter is equivalent to 1,000 milliliters. Okay, so don't forget this one. 1 liter is equals to 1,000 ml. So the symbol is ml, milliliters. Okay, ml. And the symbol of liter is L. You can see like this, like that. And sometimes big capital letter L. So liter, okay? 1 liter, how many milliliters? How many ml? 1,000 ml or milliliters. So this example here, this one, this jug, has the capacity of 1 liter, which means 1,000 ml, milliliters. Okay, because 1 liter is equals to 1,000 milliliters. So that is called standard units because exact measurement with number in it. Okay, these are the standard units of measuring volume and capacity. Okay, so again, 1 liter is equals to 1,000 milliliters. Another example here. So in this example, the volume of liquid is what? You can see here, the volume of liquid is in the 500. Okay, so meaning the volume is 500 milliliters. Okay, ml, milliliters. And if you add more liquid or water in it, so this jug here has the capacity of, you can see here the number, 600 ml. So this jug has the capacity of 600 ml. But in this example, you can see only the amount of water is in the level of 500 ml. So the volume, this is called volume of water or liquid, is 500 ml. But the jug has the capacity of 600 ml. Like that. So I hope you understand there and you are following me. Anyway, you can ask question if you have clarification or if you have questions later. Okay, just follow and listen carefully. Next here. Okay, so let me ask you, what is the volume of this jar or this jug? Find the volume and capacity of this jug and can. Okay, what's your answer here? What do you think? First, Swan, capacity of the jug, what is the capacity? Based on the number, what can you see there in the number? What is the capacity? Tell me, anybody? Huh? What is the capacity of the jug? Anybody? Oh, very good. So, the capacity, this one, capacity of the jug is 100 ml, 100 milliliters. Now, what is the volume of water? The volume of water is 50. Okay, this one. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So that's the volume of water. Okay, how about the second one? The can here. What is the capacity of the can? What is the capacity of the can? This one.
1 liter.
Yeah, very good. So the can here, based on the number, has the capacity of 1,000 ml or 1 liter. Okay. 1 liter or 1 L. Okay. So, what is the volume of juice? Volume of juice.
100 ml.
Huh? 0.
100.
Yeah, 100. 300 ml. 300. 300 ml. Okay. ml. Oops. Okay. So, that's the example here, and I hope you understand this one, how to find out the capacity of a container and also the volume of liquid inside it. Okay, let's continue here. This morning, we are going to talk about comparing volumes and capacity. Okay, compare. Let's learn how to compare. Okay, so for example here, sample. So we have here container A, container B, and container C. Let's compare the volume of water of these three containers. So you can see here that container A has less water than container B. Okay, so container A, this one, has less water compared to container B. Okay, container B. And if you compare container B to container C, so look at here, the level of water and the level of water of container C. So meaning container B has more, okay? Has more water than container C. Okay, so if you compare two things class, you need to write done, okay? Done, less water than, more water than, like that, okay? In volume, in comparing volumes and capacities. All right, so another example here. Okay, look at here. Glass A and glass B are of the same size. So they have the same size, right? The two glasses have the same height of juice. Okay, so you can see here in this picture, the same height of juice. Now, what do you think if you compare these two glasses of water? Huh? What do you think? If you are asked to compare these two glasses of water, how will you say it? Prim? Somebody is answering. Yeah, what's your answer? How will you compare it? Anybody before I show you the yes? How will you compare it? Huh? What's that?
Equal to.
Oh, very good. That's correct. Very good. So obviously, okay. So as you can see in the picture, the same size and also the same height of juice. So the same. Look at here, the same. So meaning glass B has an equal. Oh, they are equal amount of juice as glass A. Okay, so they are equal. Okay. All right. Another example here. Okay. How about this? How about this? Container C and container D are of the same size. Okay, the same size. The water level in container D is no. Container C. This is C. Okay. So look at here. The water level in container C is higher. Now, if you compare these two, you need to what? Just remember, huh? If you compare two things, just more than, less than, something like that. Okay. So container D. I'm sorry, I forgot. Container C has more than water. Container D. Okay. Container. I changed the picture and I did not change the word here, the letter. Okay. All right. So if you compare these two containers, container C has more water than, so you're comparing two things, two containers, so more water than container D. Okay. And if you compare D to C, so container D has less, okay, more, less. So remember these words. If we compare volumes and capacity, less water than container C. Okay, so that is how to compare these two containers here. All right, so let's proceed to the next here. Another example. Oh, look at here. We have here jug, mug, okay, jug, mug, and cup. So both of these three, what we call measuring cups or jug and mug, they have water inside, and then if you put the water, all waters into this container, and this is the result, the level of water. Okay, so you can see here that the volume of water in the cup, okay, look at here, the cup, because look at the level of water here, is less than the volume of water in the mug. Okay, mug, this one, the mug, less, because look at the result here. Yeah. And then another one here, if you compare the volume of water in the jug, okay, the jug, this one, okay, is what? More than the volume of water in the mug. So if you compare jug and the mug, so jug has more water. Okay, so the jug, the volume of water in the jug is more than the volume of water in the mug. Therefore, the jug has the most amount of water. So the jug has the most amount of water. Okay. Another here. Another one. Example. Look at here. We have five containers or glasses. We have container A, container B, C, D, E. So let's try to compare these five containers. If you look at this, all five containers have different amounts of water. Different amounts of water, right? You can see here, different amounts. And also here, container C. Okay, this one, container C. Container C has the most amount of water. The most amount of water, because the level of water is here. Okay, letter C. Oh, no, no, not letter C. Container C. Okay, next, if you can see here in the picture, container B has the least. Okay, container B, this one, container B has the least. If you compare the five containers, so you can see here, B has the least amount of water. And then, if you go to the volume of water in container B, if you compare this container B to container C, B to C, if you compare these two containers, container B is less than the volume of water in container C. Okay, are you following there? Next, if you go to container A, okay, look at here, container A, volume of container A, this one, is what? Compared to container B, if you compare these two, has more water, has more water, or is more than the volume of water in container B. Look at here, the level of water is here. All right, now if you go to the volume of water in container A and compare to container E, A and E, this one, okay. If you look at the picture, container A is what? They are equal. See? Container A is equal to the volume. The volume of container A is equal to the volume of container E. So they are equal. See here? Yeah, equal, right? Equal. Yeah. So this is how to compare the volume of water in different containers. So we use the word less than the volume, like that, more than the volume, or the least amount of water or liquid, or the most amount of water. So something like that. All right. So I'll give you just two exercises here. Okay. No, no, four. I think four items. Look at the picture. Let me ask you and try to guess your answer here. So just write equal to, less than, and more than. Okay.
This is in the book.
No, no, no. It's not in your book. Later, I will tell you the page of your book. Okay. This is just an example. Practice in your mind. Just try it. Just try it. Okay. What we have learned in our discussion a while ago. All right. Look at here. I cannot see. Okay, so number one, the volume of juice in bottle A is blank. The volume of juice in bottle B. What's your answer?
More than.
Oh, very good. More than. Number two, what's your answer? The volume of juice in bottle B is?
Less than.
Huh?
Less than.
B and C. So B and C. Oh, very good. The answer is less than. Okay. Okay, letter number three. What's your answer?
Equal to.
Bottle A and bottle C. This one. They are is equal to. Equal to. Very good. Number four.
More than.
C to D. C to D. Yes. More than. Okay, very good. Do you understand now how to compare? Hello?
Hi.
Understand?
Yes.
Okay, good. Let's go to your book. Okay, let's go to your book. Let's try to answer page 116. Open your book, page 116 up to 119. Okay, are you ready? Oh, this one. Fill in the boxes with equal to, less than, and more than. Number one. There are three here. So look at your book. The volume of juice in bottle C is what?
More than.
C compared to A. More than. Very good. More. Done. Okay, number two or number one. Second.
Less than.
Bottle B to C. Bottle B to C. Less than. Very good. That's correct. Less than. Not number three. A to B. This one. A to B.
Less than.
Volume of juice in bottle A is less than. Very easy, right? So less than, we compare the volume of juice bottle A and bottle B. All right, let's go to the next here. Okay, still number one and letter B. Number one, letter B. What's the answer here? Compare the tab. Tab A, B, and C. So the volume of water in tab A is what?
More than.
More than. Very easy, right? More than. Okay, next. Number one, letter B. And the second. Huh? Tab B. Tab B and C is equal, right?
Equal to.
Yeah, very good.
Equal to.
Equal to. Okay. Right. Next. Number two. Fill in the box. Says with more or less.
Hello, teacher.
Yes.
Teacher. 116.
Just follow. To 119. Yes, any question? 116. Start from 116. 16, 17, 18, 19. Okay? Until 119. Okay. Number two. We are now number two. Okay, look at here. Compare container A, B, C, D. Oh, A, B, C, D. Compare A and B. This one, A and B. More or less?
Container less than.
A. Yeah, no, not less than, more and less. You just answer more or less because there is already done here. Okay, so less because there is already done. Less than. So just choose which is the correct answer here, more or less. Okay, number two, next. What's the answer? A to C.
More.
A, container A to C. Yeah, more. Very good.
More.
Yeah, very good. Just look at the picture and compare. Last, B and D, container B and D.
More.
Yes, it's more. Less, more, more. Yeah, less, more, more. Very good. That's it. Very good. Okay, we have how many minutes left? 3 minutes more. Okay, let's finish this one. There are a few exercises left here. Let's go to page 118. Yeah, 118 and 19. Yeah, here. Okay, let's go to here. Number one. Compare and fill in the blanks. So look at here, orange juice, apple juice, grape juice. Just count how many, okay? Now, there are how many cups of grape juice than orange juice? Grape juice, how many more? Orange, how many orange? Two, four, six.
Six.
Grape juice, how many? 15, right?
15.
How about apple juice? How many? 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, now there are more blank, more cups of grape juice than orange juice. So 15 minus 6. What's the answer? 9, correct? Is this correct? 15 minus 6. So there are 9 more cups of grape juice than orange juice. Number two. Oh, almost time. 2 minutes. Let's make a little bit faster here. Anyway, you can review this video. There are fewer cups orange juice than apple juice. 8 minus 6. 2, correct? So there are 2 fewer cups of orange juice than apple juice. Okay, that's how to calculate and find the number of cups comparing the different juices here. All right, so let's go to the last one. 1 minute. Oh, 1 minute more. This one, aquarium has more water. What aquarium? A, B, C?
A.
Aquarium. Oh, very good. Aquarium A, very easy. Number two, aquarium equal. What aquarium? Equal, very easy. B, equal volume, equal. So B and C, equal. All right. The last one here. Let's go to the last one. Okay. Bucket A has less water than bucket. Bucket B, correct? Two. Oh, no, 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 no. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Then bucket C, right? Bucket has less amount of water. Bucket. Bucket B. Letter C. Bucket what? More water than bucket A.
C.
Letter D. Bucket what? Has the most water. Amount of water. C. Okay. Oh, no more. No more time. Thank you very much. And you can review this video so that we can